Drones range anywhere from $1,000 to $10,000 or more, but the sweet spot is really around $2,500 with the Phantom 4 Pro. It's a great drone with good image quality as well as exchangeable batteries, and unless you need the features of flying in higher winds or sub-zero temperatures, really the Phantom 4 is going to be the best drone for a midsize insurance company. So my favorite thing about the Phantom 4 Pro is really the image quality. It's a full 20 megapixel sensor, so it's able to take a really great photo. The batteries are also relatively inexpensive. They last a long time and they're very quick to recharge. You can generally recharge them in an hour to an hour and a half to get them back into the rotation. The drone's also very inexpensive, you know, around $2,000 for the drone, including the kit. It's a great deal. The downsides, it's not water resistant like some of the upper end drones are. It can't fight winds at the same rate some of the bigger drones like the Inspire and the Matrice have the capability of flying in higher winds. And it also can't fly in sub-zero temperatures. It doesn't have battery warmers or some of the other material that's used to keep the drone aloft in colder temperatures. The Phantom is really the best daily driver of all of the drones. If you're going to have to do multiple inspections, 4 or 5 a day, you're going to want a Phantom 4 because of the interchangeable batteries and the extremely good image quality despite its low price. There's really two things about the Mavic that are special. The first is its portability. It's able to fold up, you can stick it in your pocket, or you can carry it on an airplane if you need to. The other thing, it's got a really reasonable price point. Usually around $1,500 will get you a full kit. The cons for the Mavic are, it only has a 12 megapixel camera compared to the Phantom 4's 20. It also can only fly for about 15 minutes on average. It does have a 20 minute battery life, but it rarely can make that during a mission. So the Mavic is really good for the occasional insurance inspection, somebody who's not going to use it every day, but maybe once or twice a week. The Inspire has a dual battery setup. In case it needs to emergency land, it can do it with just one battery. It's got an exchangeable camera payload, so not only can it take traditional photos, but it can also take thermal photos. And it self-heats, so the drone can be flown in sub-zero temperatures. The Inspire is a big, heavy drone with a lot of moving parts that are very expensive in case they break. And while the dual battery setup is great for safety, it also means that you have to have two very expensive batteries and you have to charge them as well. The other thing is the drone overall is very expensive. You're basically starting at $3,000 and it's not hard to customize it upwards of $9,000 to $10,000 depending on the payload that you want. The Inspire is a great drone if you're going to be doing flights below sub-zero, but it does come with a heavy price tag. The Matrice is waterproof. It can fly in light rain. Also, because of its steadiness, it can fly in probably the highest wind speeds of any of the drones that we've talked about. It also has the ability to attach any of the cameras like the Inspire can, which means it takes a really great picture. It's very expensive. When we priced ours out with accessories, it was well over $10,000. It's also very heavy and it requires assembly on each flight and you have to take it apart to put it back in the case. The Matrice is going to be the best drone for commercial inspections, sub-zero inspections, as well as high winds because of its flight stability. Drones bigger than the Matrice are really out of the question for insurance inspections. They maybe fit in areas where you're doing like wind turbine or corridor mapping or using special sensors, but they don't make sense for using them in the insurance industry.